Captain America was kind of, was that like the second one after Iron Man, I think, was it? It was one of the early ones. So, I mean, I knew what Marvel was. I grew up Fantastic Four and Spider-Man. I loved all that. You know, obviously being in the UK, we didn't really know Captain America as much, but I knew who he was as a character. Yeah, so when they said you're working on it, any Skinny Steve, I had to look at the character. I had to look at the comic, and I read the issues with some Skinny Steve stuff and getting an idea. I went, oh, okay, I get it. He's about my height and he's skinny and yeah, he's a bit of a nerd. All right, I like it. But it was fun. I mean, everyone was cool and it was a great atmosphere. But I spent most of it with Lola Effects, and it was in their studio developing it in pre-production. So it was mainly me and Lola, and Joe Johnson would come in and check the stuff. And obviously when I got auditioned for it, I can't remember if Chris was there, but Joe Johnson was definitely there. And what they did is they lined up a load of Skinny Steves in a line. And it was as simple as that. And it was, they had varying heights. And I think I was about in the middle. And Joe and the assistants just looked at the line and just came over to me and just said, what's your name? I said, boy, can you act? So I was like, yeah, yeah. He went, okay, you got a job. I said, but I didn't know what the job was, you know. Next thing, they had my top off and they're taking pictures. And I'm like, oh, okay, it's one of those jobs. Oh, right. But yeah, they're all very nice and people. But I worked a lot with visual effects. And then on set, Chris was there, and there was another guy called Leander. Now, Leander did the majority of the body doubling after the pre-production and after the recruitment scene. That's all Leander. So I was there from the start, and I was a very small part of a big effect. So I can't claim to be the character. It's Chris's character, and I helped, and Leander helped, and that was it, really. But yeah, it was good fun. Because not only was it people, a lot of people think it's just head replacement. It's not. It's pretty much skin replacement as well. I remember looking at it and people saying, oh, so it's your body with his head. No. I think that the my contribution when they used me there was a reference for the movement, you know, and also for the other actors and obviously for the height and technically for the camera. It was very technical in that way. So it wasn't just simple. It was like taking his head and just sticking it on. But how they actually did it from then on. Lola showed me the tests and then, but the rest of it, I have no idea what they did till I saw it.
On set, when you did some of that Skinny Steve, did it put on any practical effects just to, so it can emerge?
They had, I had orange dots on my face.
Oh, for the tracking?
Yeah, for the tracking, and on my chest. Leander, when he did his passes, they gave him prosthetics. So he had, I think they gave him like a, because we were both together on that scene. And I think they gave him nose, maybe brow. I don't know, but he definitely had a prosthetics on there so that he looked more like Chris. So basically, Chris would do a pass. It was the scene where you see with the newspaper the first time, you know, comes down and gets up. So I'd get up, then I'd walk over to the podium, do the lines. The actor was there. Can't remember the guy. British actor, but he was doing American. He'd deliver the line, and then Chris would do it. Then Leander would do it, and then, I don't know, then they, whatever they did.